Let's do this. Right,
Perfect.
Aki Kareem here for BBTV. I am delighted to be joined by the former IBO champion, the former WBA super welterweight champion of the world, Anna Rankin, the classical warrior, not the banger that Boxrec is saying that you are the banger. You're actually the classical warrior. What's going on?
Don't know. I don't know. Boxrec's having a moment.
Now, you are on this really good card. It's a fight zone in collaboration with the BBC. So let's start off with that. It's this Friday, Wolverhampton. I'm
Yeah.
looking forward to it. I'm going to be the ring MC right there in the action. But tell me how this deal came down then, because it's quite a big move, this, and it's a big step and a good platform, isn't it?
It's massive. Like for myself as a female fighter, and as a former world champion, I want people to have the opportunity to watch boxing, and being able to watch it on iPlayer on the BBC is like the ultimate goal, you know, because everyone can tune in. It means it's not only available to certain people, they don't have to pay to watch it and things like that. So yeah, I'm really, really happy about that. And also it's great to have boxing on the BBC again. That's what we want. So yeah, no, can't complain. Very, very excited.
It's a really good headline fight, Ricky Summers and Joel McIntyre. We love an English title fight. But do you also think that the strong quality of female fights on this card is what has actually tipped the balance as well for the BBC to say, yeah, let's do this?
Absolutely. Like we're living in a time right now where women's sport is starting to get the sort of the limelight that it does deserve, just a little bit more you know, screen time basically. I think like, you know, Sky Sports is backing women's sport as well. Everything's behind it. So it's about time that we were going to give it some airtime. So I think that has definitely drawn it in for the BBC, but also equally I'm all about, you know, equality, and I actually want people to watch boxing, like good, exciting boxing, and all of the cards on the BBC, all the fights on the card on the BBC are great, exciting matchups, and I think that's what people want to see. People want to see exciting fights. They don't want to see like, you know, so like I'm a former world champion. I wouldn't be going in with the journeywoman next. Do you know what I mean? It's they want to see good matchups like that.
And you know, people have been asking me actually, and I don't know the answer myself. Is this a multi-fight deal? Is it a fight night by fight night basis? Do you know the ins and outs of that?
I'm afraid I can't. I don't know everything about it, to be honest. I've just been fully focused on training. But I know that this is the start. I think it's the start of something really good, you know, and I hope it is for going forward, because there's you know, there's so much scope for exciting fights and big nights of boxing to come out on the BBC. So fingers crossed, we'll make it an exciting start this Friday. But hopefully with more shows to come, because that would be fantastic.
Let's talk about your fight then. As you say, it's a comeback fight, so to speak. You're in there with
Yeah.
Logan Holler, who I've just checked her
Yep.
out. She looks like a very solid fighter. You know, solid record, good pro. She's from Columbia, South Carolina, in America. So she's coming over here to upset the
Yep.
apple cart, and you've got to stop her.
Absolutely. Yep, that's the goal. So I think this is a fantastic matchup for myself. You know, obviously, like I said, after losing my world titles in my last fight, it wasn't the best performance of myself. I wasn't myself in the ring on that night, and had a lot to deal with going forward from that. But you know, for me, I always feel if you're coming back as a, you know, comeback fight after losing your world titles, you should be in there against somebody of top level. She's ranked number eight with the WBA. I'm number two with the WBA. So it's kind of a, for me, it's a good matchup, an exciting fight for the fans. That's what I wanted first and foremost. And I want to get in there with someone who's going to, you know, bring it on fight night, and we can put on a show for everybody.
Is there some sort of international or intercontinental title on the line, or is it really just for the ranking that you're going after here?
Yeah, no, there's no title or anything on the line. This is my comeback fight, so I want to go out there and put on a show. So, you know, I didn't need any titles attached to it or anything, but I wanted it to be a good fight for people to watch. So that's why we're fighting Logan Holler.
You know, your resume is actually, if you look at your resume, the quality of opponents that you have consistently fought, it's very, very high. I mean, no one can argue with your resume, can they, really?
Absolutely not. And that's precisely another reason why I picked a solid opponent for my comeback fight. You know, I've never been about taking the easy option. That's just not me as a fighter. And I think, like you said, my resume says that. I fought everybody anywhere, all over the world. And, you know, for me, it was always going to be somebody who's going to come up and turn up for an exciting fight and I want to win. So, yeah, I'm really excited about it, to be honest.
How far ahead do you plan? I know you've just said you focus everything onto Friday night. You know, the attention's there, 10th of March, Wolverhampton. But there must, because you're very ambitious and you've also been at the top before, is yep. everything now sort of like treading water until you get a title shot again? Or is that not how you look at, how do you actually look at it and plan your career out?
So me and the team sat down. Obviously, my goal is to become a 3-times world champion for Scotland. Like, first and foremost, take another world title belt back to Scotland. That is the dream, you know? To do that for my country would be the utmost like epicness as far as I'm concerned. I'd be really happy. And from my own personal point of view as well, you know, I feel I belong as a world champion. I feel that's where I should be. So this is just one step further forward to achieving that goal. I don't like to look too far ahead. I always like to take each fight as they come. But, you know, long term, I'm looking to become world champion again. So obviously it's challenging, like rematch with Terry Harper or challenging the likes of Tasha Jonas, because these are the people at the top of the super welterweight division right now. And these people have the belts that I want.
Yeah, and the top fighters, the great ambassadors of the sport, as you are yourself. And it'd be great to see you in the mix with all them. Now, tell me about, like, the this is a bit of an interesting one, because if you look at someone like Natasha Jonas, who's, you know, a little bit older than you, and, you know, but still having an absolute Indian summer, like, you know, people like Terry Harper moving in weight, finding other avenues. In the female game, is there sort of like a longer shelf life, do you think, for fighters?
Yes, I do feel like that. I feel also because we come into the sport maybe a little bit later, you know, like, and as you see, there's a lot more women who are older than the guys, you know, starting to be quite successful in their older years. And I think we mature a little bit quicker, but then, you know, you get your women's strength and we can prolong it for longer, I think, at the moment, because we're not starting out the same as the guys at really, really young age, just as much as they are. And there's not so much wear and tear. Like on my body, for example, I didn't go through the amateur system. So I don't have the same sort of wear and tear on my body that somebody that maybe did go through that system all the way through to now. And, you know, I think because we do go between the weight classes, it can allow for certain success later on in our careers, because we can change the weight classes. So, you know, look at Tasha there. She stepped up. She's at 154 now. And like you said, having an Indian summer, she's doing amazingly well. So, you know, sometimes a change of weight class is great for a fighter, but also I think with the girls, it's definitely something that we can do and we can actually excel at.
Do you feel then, having said that, that you're actually, with the learning experiences you've had, with the quality opposition, do you feel that you may actually be really at your peak now, coming into your peak?
Yeah, and I've definitely felt that this training camp. I've really pushed my limits this camp, being up in Abertay at the university, and my body is just starting to really peak now, and I'm starting to see some really exciting things develop in my own abilities, my skills, and how my body's changing. It's just incredible, you know. And even though I'm a bit older than maybe some of the younger kids coming through now, I feel like this is me just hitting my peak right now, and it's very, very exciting.
A lot of the female fighters, not just the female fighters, but it's topical, obviously, at the minute. A lot of the female fighters I speak to are becoming a lot more scientific in their approach to boxing, just like the men's game has. People like Carl Froch really started this years ago. Very scientific, very analytical with their regimens. How scientific is your approach to training and boxing?
Very. You know, for me, I think, you know, it's really important that we now start to get some proper research done into female athletes across all sports. Before, we've had the money in the guys, but not in the girls. But now we have the money is now starting to come in, and we're starting to get the interest from people. So a lot of people are starting to do research. So that's why I had my training camp has been based up at Abertay University. I've done a collaboration with them, and I work alongside Andrew Usher, who's my sports science guy, and John Barbary, who's head of performance there in sports science. And they do they're doing research, and it's world leading research into the performance for combat athletes like female combat athletes. So, you know, this is the first kind of research ever done of its kind. Kirsty Babington came up and took part. She joined me for sparring. So all my sparring partners have come up. We've sparred on the Fridays. They've done the testing for the research on the Saturdays. And then we sparred again on the Sunday. And it's meant that it's allowed the opportunity to have all these elite female athletes in one place to get their data, to then be able to put forward the information for research. And that's something really, really special. I'm very, very proud to be part of that. And looking forward, hopefully part of my legacy will be that in Scotland, you know, the knowledge that we're learning that can actually help develop future fighters. And potentially, maybe another world champion to come out of Scotland, which would be incredible.
I'd put money on it. I mean, I was the ring announcer for the Commonwealth Games, and I was really impressed with the Scottish national team. There were some great gems, both female and male. And I can see that the system in Scotland seems to have changed, and they're putting a lot more into the youngsters now. And perhaps this is what you were talking about, particularly young girls as well, which is topical, can get that intervention at an early age.
Definitely. And the work that Andrew and John have been doing, they've been working with young amateurs in the local area. They're working a lot with loads of different male boxers and female boxers. And this is information and, you know, research that's done on the performance and how you can develop better cognitive skills in the corner with your recovery being improved. And how do we improve recovery to allow that? And then ultimately, overall, I think you're probably looking at an increased safety in the sport, because, you know, if you're able to increase your recovery time, it means your performance can go up. It means you're more cognitive in the corner, you're taking more information, and therefore ultimately perform better. And that's what we all want as athletes, is to perform at our best. So this sort of research, I think, is paramount. I think it's really important, and I'm very proud to be part of it.
Fantastic. Well, look, it's going to be a great night on Friday. Looking forward to your fight. Make sure you tune in, guys. It's going to be on BBC iPlayer, which is free for everybody to watch. Friday night, the show starts the live card, approximately 8 p.m. Hannah will be on as a co-main feature against Logan Holler from the United States. Is there anything you want to say as a final message to your supporters?
No, only just thank you so much for your constant support. It's always worth its weight in gold. You can't explain to you how much us fighters out there appreciate your support. Thank you to all the people who are coming along to watch live, but also to all of you that are going to tune in on the BBC, because it's going to be an exciting night of boxing. Not only my fight, but all the fights on the card are really great matchups. So it's definitely one to get involved in. And thank you again for all the support.